Good to go.
Ready to go. Okay. Hello, everybody out there on the screens. I hope everyone is safe and sound in this present situation. That's, I think, the most important thing. So, feel very warm welcome from this point of view. Good to have you in again. So, what's the idea of having this session today?
So, we're going to start a couple of videos with this video today, and it's a whole different setup than the earlier videos, because before we had different machines, just explained the machines, built some small things, just example pieces. But in the next couple of videos, we're going to build a whole bench from scratch, basically. And today we're going to start with the sawing process. So we're going to talk about the miter saw, we're going to talk about the plunge saw,
We talk about the big one.
The big one. We haven't had that one in the video yet. And I think that's probably going to sum up today, because we're going to run out of time very quickly again. And I'd say we're just gonna start.
Yep. Don't let us lose too much time. So I will just give you a rough idea what we are talking about today. So we have over here a one by one sketch just to explain and to take some measurements if we doubt. Although we have a list over here as well, which indicates all and everything, and that might be available later on the internet as well. So for you, if you want to make one on your own, it's quite easy. So we're gonna have a couple of different parts. So just let me point out this. That's gonna be the back support. We have the front leg, we have the cross stringers, and we have right here a longitudinal stringer to connect the whole thing.
That one right there.
That's gonna be it, yeah. On top you have the seat moldings, these ones, and the rest moldings for your back. So this is what we're gonna cut to size on the miter saw later on. And first of all, we have to divide our massive pieces of timber.
Yeah.
So what would your recommendation be to do this?
So I'd first cut it just in half, so it's a bit more manageable. And therefore, I would just move it to the big miter saw.
That's heavy.
What's that? Did you need some help?
I was joking. Had good lunch today.
So, got me good.
Yeah, as always.
So, talking about the big one.
So, roughly the center. So, just to find the center, it's quite easy if you have these both supports. As you can see, we have our KS120 over here. In the set version, which means we have this trolley already, so just nice and easy to fold out and to have a bench mounted saw. On the left and on the right we have these extension tables, also fitted with a scale. You can also easily match the scale related to your saw blade. So once you have to do a repetitive cut, it's quite easy. You can line up that stop after your scale and you will have an exact measurement from the end of the stop to your saw blade.
But right now, just to cut it in half, we can just check basically the markings.
So we are here close to 120, here we are at 135, so that means, what can you see now, 128?
122.
22.
3, 4, 5.
Perfect, centered.
Awesome.
Spot on. Yeah. So just to have some more handy parts. Always important to double check whether you have connected a dust extraction. In this case, we always recommend on miter saws to use a thick 36 millimeter hose. Why?
Because it produces a lot of sawdust and chips and you don't want your small hose to clog.
That's it. So it's connected on the outside, on the outer diameter of the connector, not on the inside. And to get more efficiency in the dust extraction, it's quite neat if you have a thicker hose, because it creates more airflow.
So,
did you see some dust?
Nope.
Very little only. Yeah? So, just like always, it's all about defined dust. That's what we really catch quite efficient with these big air volume. So there might be some smaller or bigger chips which are
It's still a miter saw.
That's not too bad.
So, and the miter saw is really hard to get all the dust out of. And if you have some kickback with some pieces of wood, the back piece is made out of rubber, so it doesn't break. That's quite handy.
Well, just put the other pieces of wood aside.
So now we have to cut the top part, which is slightly beveled.
That's it. So we're gonna do this cut. So that's, if you imagine the wood, more or less a parallel cut. So we cut parallel to the grain, which requires a special saw blade. Makes life easier if you have the right saw blade, which is already fitted on our saw, but we will give you a short explanation in a minute.
So basically what we need now as measurement, we need the top part, and I think that's 5 centimeters, isn't it?
Yeah, that's what you have right here. So we marked it already.
Okay.
It's 5.
Yep.
And the overall length is 880. So it's 880.
And then we need the difference between those two marks.
So that starts at a height of, let me just get this,
383. Maybe I need some glasses.
Yeah, that's pretty much this one.
Oh, I already marked that too. So basically you only need those two marks, the one down here and the one up here. Put on your rail, your guide rail, and just make the cut.
So that will look like this. And today we have chosen our legendary MFT table, because it's also very smart to work with. But as you can see, we have only a very little support. And that's why, just to make things more perfect, I would like to support the guide rail with my second part, just to have it a little bit more stable.
So you only need basically a second piece with the same dimensions.
That's it.
And that make, not just in this case, if you cut smaller pieces that are not really wide, just put a couple of them next to each other, and then you have a good surface to put your guide rail on.
So if you want, you can attach one of the G-clamps right there from underneath and fold it in or slide it in. I would just use one fill.
Okay.
Hold on a second.
Oh, yep.
And just slide it in like that.
That's handy. Okay. And you're just going to use one.
I'm just going to use one because the weight of the machine should be
sufficient
enough to hold it in place. No, that doesn't work at all. At present.
Yeah, the angle is not right.
No, we have to make it a different way. Okay, plan B. I'm just going to line it up.
Oh, now you're just going to clamp it to the table.
That's what I want to do. Because then I'm a bit more flexible. Just line up the material after my marks.
And how are you going to save the other piece of wood that you don't basically cut it? Or is that a piece is going to be discarded?
No, I'll just push it aside. So the only intention is to have a stable guide rail, and that's enough.
Right, so you just need enough room between the two pieces.
Just to plunge in. Yeah.
So to plunge in the saw, get the right depth on the saw so you don't cut through the table and be good to go.
But in this case, don't tighten the G-clamp too much because you might bend the track.
Yeah.
So, and we talked about this earlier. So today we have, because of the bigger piece of timber, the TS55 in the big version, which is the TS75, all the settings you know from a TS55, such as speed control, saw blade change with a fast fix lever, soft start function, electronic brake, and all this stuff. That setting is pretty much the same as we know this from our TS55.
So same game with that one. If you use it on a rail, always adjust it first so it runs smoothly and precisely.
Take out this clearance here.
So everything is basically the same.
Absolutely.
Just bigger, stronger.
What I double check is, of course, the cutting depth. So I'm now at 65 millimeters and add some 2 millimeters more just to make sure that I'm completely cutting through.
So you can basically use the MFT and cut into it up to 5 millimeters. That's the recommendation, because if you go any further, you might cut through the profiles on the outside or through those screws that are in every corner to hold the plate down.
Same issue here. We have a massive saw with a lot of power, with a lot of cutting depth, creating a lot of dust.
Yeah.
So same game again. I choose the next bigger hose. In this time, I've chosen the tapered hose. Mm-hmm. So that's the one from 32 expanding to 36. So that's a perfect compromise between performance on the dust extraction and handling, because it's still lighter than the full 36 millimeter hose, right?
And same as with the miter saw, the bigger hoses go around the dust exit basically, and the smaller hoses fit into it. So there's no need to get a different part. They all work the same way.
Plug it cable,
always handy. Oh yeah, just showing off.
Just put it out like this. It's one of my favorites. All right, there we go. So first cut, it's the deepest.
Wait. Yeah.
Experienced guys. Okay.
Learn from past mistakes.
Ready to run?
Yeah.
So we talked about it earlier, so we add the proper saw blade. So in this case I've chosen the Panda saw blade because I have pretty nice ripping cut.
Yep.
And as you can see on the surface, it's not too bad.
No, it's a really good cut.
No burn marks, nothing. That would have happened with the standard blade, because it's for that application just too fine.
Yeah.
So that always makes sense to have a coarser blade, because we anyway have to sand it later on.
Yeah. And you would have had to push way harder with a finer blade too, so that just makes your life easier.
To change the blade is, as explained, exactly the same like we have done it for the TS55. We have this fast fix lever, we fold it out, and as soon as we've done this, we find the right place to get access to this fixing bolt. Finally, it's not a mistake if you undo the plug-it cable. If you forget it, nevertheless, you would be safe at all, because the switch is mechanically blocked, so you can't hurt yourself. And the last function, of course, I think you touched it already.
Yeah, it's already.
Is the spindle locking mechanism, so that you can comfortably work with just one key.
One difference here, though, the tool to basically change the blade is also included with the saw, and right here I'm going to show you on my small camera. It's hidden on the base and not up here in the side, if you're wondering.
Yeah, because it has to be a longer one.
Yeah.
Because the torque on that bit blade is much bigger than, or much higher than on the TS55, where you find some place right there.
Yeah.
So, right now let's cut this second part. Just put this aside. And after that we cut both parts to their
length.
Final height. Yeah. So it's smoother, I think, this one.
Not yet marked.
Yeah.
Nein.
No. So what did we say? We had 50.
Yeah.
And 880.
880, and the other one was 383.
Overall length.
I'm not mistaken. Yeah, 383.
383. This is right there.
There we go. Yeah, that's also important. I don't know if you can see that on the camera, but the pieces of wood always have rounded edges, basically, and if you don't mark it all the way down, you will cut it too short. or not long enough, depending on what you're going for.
So, just for better visibility, I draw a longer line. That helps me in lining up the guide rail in a proper way. And finally, do the same thing. Just support the guide rail. Could you line up that for me, Phil? He's very accurate.
Of course I am.
That's how I know him. Let me know when you're there.
Yep, good to go.
All right. So, second cut.
Quickly sand it down.
Yeah, it's all about finding the right choice for your tools you need for your applications that really helps you to work efficiently. Yeah.
Just so you can see, we cut them individually.
It's not too bad for a beginner.
Decent.
Good. So now our next step would be to cut the overall length.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so you already marked it.
80. Yeah. So we could now set our repetitive stop on the saw. And maybe we could finally, or before we could show how to line up the
nice.
Ruler. So just take for example, a straight measurement, whatever you might choose, let's say 800, or let's go to 880. That's
880, yeah, the one we need.
So we don't need to move it later on. So we set this to 880. And as you all know, we have our KS120 coming in with a laser that indicates both sides of the saw blade, which is important. So I can activate the laser, and then it's quite easy to just put my ruler against the stop and double check with the laser on the right hand side, so you can see we are really spot on. So that's the initial setting. You could move that entire extension table a fraction in or out just to line up or to calibrate your scale. Exactly. And once you've done this, that's it.
Yeah, just once basically in your lifetime, or as long as you need the saw.
The same has to happen, of course, on the opposite side. On the left-hand side, you would do exactly the same. And now if you just end up on this stop.
The measurement we did. Noise.
Again. Yeah, fits.
Snuggly.
Now, just to, if it has to be accurate, I always recommend to use that clamp, because the parts might be twisted slightly, and so that helps getting a better accuracy.
And you can use that on both sides, so you could just basically plug it out and use it on the other side if you have to switch sides.
Yep. There we go.
So two pieces done. What's up next?
Actually, we would cut the cross stringer, which is this one. That's a
we need two of those.
60 by 60. That's this one. Yeah, 400 in length.
Easy.
Easy.
That's doable. 60 by 60.
Yep.
So that's that part right there. So we can basically just cut off one side snugly. Yep. So it just
to make it square. And that's the point when we basically have to flip around the clamp just to be sure that this is nicely in place.
Yep.
You only can remove that clamp if you fold it to the rear. And that's the same way how to take it. So here, this way it's locked. So that's the way you take it out. And on the other hand, you would put it back to the base, same way, fold it around, just to keep that one in place.
And that one always comes with the saw.
It's always coming as standard with the saw. So now you could see I was stopping or let the machine run out while I was still plunged in.
Yeah.
Be aware of this, because if you release the saw blade with a running saw blade, such small cutoffs might be fired away. That's really tricky.
That okay. Happens you said? Way more often than it should.
400.
And we don't have to double check the measurement again, because we already know that the tape
it's exactly, yeah.
Fits perfectly.
And always operate the saw with the hand you actually have not on your material. So don't yep. work in crossways, because that really is could become tricky.
And dangerous.
As this machine has not yet any saw stop functionality.
Not yet.
Yeah, maybe someday, but we'll at present it's early, too early.
There we go. Next two pieces.
Now, if you have this material already on, I think we could also do the longitudinal stringer.
One of those.
That's 940.
I'll check that.
So, by the way, with the length of that stringer, so all your seat molders, you can easily create your own width or length of your bench if you want to have three or four people seated. Maybe with the four of you, you should have a third support in the center, but up to three, I think it's quite easy to just extend or cut it longer, and you have a wider bench.
Yeah, that's very easily.
Did you send it already?
Of course.
Ah, good boy.
Like a dog. And another piece down. So, those were mainly our straight cuts.
Yeah.
So only 90 degree cuts.
That's it.
There we go.
Okay, next step. I think we have to cut the upper stringer. Mm-hmm. And as you can see, just to have the bench a little bit more comfortable for you to seat, we have a slight inclination of 5 degrees. And that's what we cut next. On that bigger timber, that's a 100 by 60 square, and we have the angle of 5 degrees.
Yep.
Just to have it racing a little bit to the front.
Mm-hmm.
Just to feel a bit more comfortable than just horizontal. So we basically do the same.
What length is it? 520?
Yep. What does it say?
It's just up here, 520. It's not
in yeah, it's a rough length, so it's 400 and 100. So it's, I think it's 500 only. So that's okay. The overall length, just to have a little bit.
Oh, okay.
Leftover of the material.
So are you gonna cut it immediately with a 5 degree angle, or cut it roughly and then?
I would do the same thing again, cutting it in half.
Mm-hmm.
Because like with this one, you can see that's really that's wood. Yeah. It
very,
might be twisted, so it's not that serious. If you cut it in half, then it becomes much easier. So probably like this. Okay, now I cut it square. And we have this angle of 5 degrees, so that's what I can easily set for the scale and lock it in place.
Okay.
Now I do an additional cut in 5 degree angle.
And that would have been a perfect piece if you would have lifted up the blade early
to fire off.
Exactly.
And now you said this was 500, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, so we're gonna set our repetitive stop. So that's the way it is. And just keep the bevel, the inclination as it is.
No reason to flip the material around because we need it exactly on the same side.
The only thing I flip around is my clamp. There we go.
So you could basically just continue on with that one. That's we don't need the... Because we cut it in half earlier, the second half we don't need for that one.
Correct.
There we go.
There we are.
Now we got those two. Just as a little bit of understanding.
Yeah, we can fold one round just to have it on the side view, so it might be looking roughly like this. That's a stringer.
Film from around your shoulder.
Jesus. The front leg is missing. So we have to cut the leg.
Yeah.
You know what I said earlier? Just to line it up, it's quite neat if you have a decent stop. The MFT table always comes in with a nice and perfect stop like this. And that helps us double checking the measurement before we are sorry later on. So this is where we line it up. And now we can easily measure, due to some tolerances, the overall length of the front leg. It's 327 exactly.
327.
Yeah. So from the long edge, so we have a 5 degree angle, of course, this 5 degree angle. From here, I think that might be too short, is it?
327 is possible.
It's possible, because otherwise we could have shown how neat the laser is. Nevertheless, I can...
You can still do that if you want.
327, I said.
Yep.
Was it 327? There we go. So if you have to do something which is shorter than your ruler on the side extension table, it's quite neat to just mark the whole thing and to use the laser to line up your material.
But you can double check it now.
Yeah, perfectly.
All right, check it.
Spot on.
There we go.
Yeah. All right, and from this one, we of course also need two parts and we need to cut it square, right? Because that one should now match right there.
Nice.
Yeah.
So we only need a second piece of that.
One. Yeah. Please. And the neat thing is that the center just rotates around this edge.
Yeah. So the pivot point is right in the middle. So you don't have to worry about.
There we go. So that's now the second leg for the second support.
Yeah, I think those are all the structural pieces. We cut the long one. I don't know where I put it though, but we did that. So we only need the seat bolts now.
Yeah. So the 940, it's this one. Now seat moldings are easy. What time do we have? So we have half an hour to go. That's, I think, still quite okay.
Yeah, that should be sufficient.
Yeah.
So we need 18 of those.
I think it was 18.
Yeah.
As we found out.
I checked it. 18, and in length, they are 1 meter and 18 centimeters. So how long are those? Well, we have a lot of cutoffs, don't we?
Yeah. It's 150.
Yeah, a lot of cutoffs. It is what it is. So what side do you want to cut on? Left or right?
I think it's something you could do. Or do you want me to do this?
I can work.
You can work as well. Are you a left or right hander?
I am a right handed, but I don't mind working with my left hand too. So that's fine.
I don't either. So let's ask Rajiv, from which side do you see more, on the left or right? Which is the visibility that is better? The rear one? Okay.
Right there.
So you're going to have.
Okay.
The right hand side.
So I think we should cut one side off neatly.
Just square, yeah.
And then move
what
on.
You should never ever do is just cut in a package. Such as this. Put it on the way, because of course you have a pull-out saw with a capacity of more than 300 millimeters, so that would be sufficient for this.
Yeah.
But it's really dangerous if you cut the package.
Yeah.
So never do more than two. Best cut it piece after piece.
So I think we should do it the correct way.
Yeah.
It's going to take some time.
Yeah, we still have pieces. Roughly half an hour.
Let's
go. So where, if you put your camera over there?
So we have the clamp. We could still use the clamp for every single cut now, but I would say for time issues, I would just go for it.
It's just a small square, so the cutting pressure is not too high. You can easily hold it in your hand.
Exactly. So we're good to go. And now that's exactly what Tommy was talking about earlier. Now I have to hold the piece that I want, so I'm going to switch hands, hold it with my right hand and cut it with my left hand. One of 18 to go.
It's cutting to size. Actually, I give you a couple of explanations, because we are not able to finish the bench today totally. So we're cutting it now to size, and in the next session we're gonna domino the supports together, and we might probably just drive some stainless steel sheets to the seat moldings into the bench, just to have it perfectly prepared for some exterior applications. We add some more additional accessories we have for the screwdriver, such as the carnosing drill, because we want to have all the carnosings in the same depth. So that's what you're gonna see in the next session.
That is it.
That's really a pleasure.
18 pieces. So we got the stuff to sit on, we got the frame. I think that's it for this video.
Yeah, because the assembly would take probably too long. That's why we might stop right here and continue this in the next session, because then we have enough to talk about how to join it,
yeah,
using the domino, explaining the domino once more,
yeah,
using the cordlesses with these countersink drills, mm-hmm, just to ensure that they are all in the same depth,
mm-hmm,
and finally using the cordless to drive in some stainless steel screw in the best case, or whatever we might have available, with the depth control to have also visual nice service, not one screw deeper than the other, and so that doesn't look nice and doesn't look professional. So that's what Festool can support. So if you have any questions, just raise your questions. Otherwise, I think we are pretty much done.
For this video, we are.
So all the best for you.
Great day. And see you next time.
Talk to you later on. Bye.
Bye.